What are you doing with all those glasses, Mark?
Well, my optometrist told me I'm getting old and that I need bifocals. It's very unfortunate. So these are my new glasses.
Are you looking at options for your vision?
I sure am. I don't love wearing bifocals. In fact, I hate them. But they do help me see better. And the options that I'm looking for are really kind of not available. The thing that I've been really interested about is accommodative intraocular lenses.
What does that mean? What is an accommodative intraocular lens?
Well, an accommodative intraocular lens is an alternative to standard cataract surgery. So in cataract surgery, they replace the natural lens with a hard piece of plastic. And unfortunately, that means that you will always have reading glasses because they don't change their focal distance from far away to near. But accommodative ones act more like your natural lens in that they are able to change their focal distance.
Okay, very interesting. So these are emerging medical devices?
They are. There is one product that exists on the market to place today. The Crystal Lens has been out for a while. It sort of works in that it provides you with a low level of accommodation. But in order to be able to read and then see things far away, you need about a diopter and a half or so of accommodation. And they often fall short of that. And they also have some challenges. So it is emerging, but we're not quite there yet.
So how does this tie into the triple Venn diagram that we went through the other day?
Yeah, that's a fun way to think about this. So accommodative intraocular lenses, and for those of you that haven't seen that video, there's links available around here somewhere. And if we think about that triple Venn diagram and think about the company first, when we think about regulatory, there is an existing predicate. When we think about business, there's a huge market. It's a $1 billion market, lots of players in the space, lots of track records. And then the product still hasn't been quite dialed in. We were just talking a bit about that. And breaking that product up into a few different areas, we have the viability, desirability, and feasibility. The viability and desirability are both fairly well understood. I think the key challenge there is people want it, but ophthalmologists that are performing these surgeries need to have it work within their workflows. The feasibility is the problem. Nobody's developed the rat trap that is able to actually figure this out to be able to provide that accommodation in a natural way.
So when do you think accommodative intraocular lenses are going to be available? When do you think you'll get yours installed?
Yes, I'm so hopeful. I am really looking forward to getting my accommodative intraocular lens. I don't know. I'm really hopeful that something comes out. There's a few companies that are out there that I've been watching and I'm super interested in. LensGen has been around for a while. They're waiting to conduct their larger clinical study. Jellysee, OmniView, Fluid Vision has been around for a long time. Synchrony, Atia Vision is a new player. And there's more that keep on coming on board. But none of them are cleared yet. They're sort of in that clinical stage, and so I'm keeping my eyes open to figure out if I can get one of those.
No pun intended.
Yeah. Yeah, cheers. Thank you.